Message from Starfleet, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
The Enterprise will proceed to the Alpha Proxima system. While the indigenous race on Proxima 3 has not reached a technological level commensurate with entering the Federation, and therefore under the protection of the Prime Directive of non-interference, we do maintain a discrete monitoring satellite. It has picked up activity from an asteroid in an elliptical orbit. You are to investigate without interfering with life on the planet.
According to the library computer, the Alpha Proxima system has five planets and an asteroid belt. A large asteroid is heading towards the inner planets and should pass close by Proxima 3. It passes through the interior of the system once every 200 years. The people of Proxima 3 call it Scythe, the same name as their god of war.
God of war, Mr. Spock? Isn't that a bit surprising from a people whose technology matches 20th century Earth?
Considering the level of warfare during that century, I'm surprised that it is Earth that did not have a god of war. In any case, about a millennium ago, Proxima 3 suffered a globally devastating war.
Blew themselves back to the Stone Age, Mr. Spock?
Late Bronze Age, Ensign. They rebuilt their world in half the time it had taken to get there originally. But the Armageddon was mythologized as a battle between the Sofs and Lukers. In that war, the planet was razed, and all the gods died except Scythe. He had rained fury down upon the world, then went off on a long dance of victory. His return is a time for worldwide soul-searching and atonement.
And Scythe returns, and our monitoring station picks up activity.
It would seem that we should proceed to Alpha Proxima and scan Scythe.
Moin zusammen und willkommen zurück zu Let's Play Star Trek 20th Anniversary. Ja, wir haben neue Befehle erhalten. Und das System ist Alpha Proxima und dann machen wir uns jetzt gleich mal auf den Weg hin. Navigation. Alpha Proxima, jetzt gucken, welches System es ist. Es müsste das hier unten sein. Ja, das ist Alpha Proxima und wir sehen uns gleich, sobald wir da sind.
Der Weltraum. Unendliche Weiten. Wir schreiben das Jahr 2200. Dies sind die Abenteuer des Raumschiffs Enterprise, das mit seiner 400 Mann starken Besatzung 5 Jahre lang unterwegs ist, um neue Welten zu erforschen, neues Leben und neue Zivilisationen. Viele Lichtjahre von der Erde entfernt, dringt die Enterprise in Galaxien vor, die nie ein Mensch zuvor gesehen
That old devil moon.
So, wir haben Alpha Proxima erreicht und werden sogleich auch in den Standardorbit gehen.
Entering standard orbit.
So, und dann müssen wir uns mal kurz sehen hier, wenn ich jetzt mit... Na, geht doch. Einmal eben mit Spooky reden.
A sensor scan of Psi reveals surface features consistent with damage left by a nuclear attack. It would seem to have been a target during Proxima's war.
Scythe rained fury down on the planet and then left on a dance of victory. A missile base, Captain?
It would seem to make sense.
Captain, I just monitored a narrow beam message from Scythe to Proxima 3. I don't have it all. I just caught a bit of the initial burst. I'm attempting a translation, but it appears to be a computer code.
Any response from the planet?
The Proxtrites will not have the equipment necessary to understand and reply to that code for another 25.6 years at their present rate of development.
Okay. Chekhov reden? Nee, können wir nicht. Dann gehen wir noch kurz in den Computer. Und zwar leben auf diesem Planeten zwei Völker, die Luca und die Softs. Und wollen wir mal kurz gucken, was uns der Computer darüber verraten kann. Luca ist, glaube ich, richtig geschrieben.
Lukas.
Ups, shit, nochmal. So.
Lukas. One of the two ancient cultures of Proxtra. See Softs. The Lukas believe that a man who made the most of his ability was a god. Their individualism put themselves at odds with the communitarianism of the Softs. The Lukas used base 3. Their organization was based on units of 3, making up sets of 99. The number 99 was known to have religious importance to them.
Okay, soweit so logisch. Ja, ne, Gruppen von 3 und dann Einheiten von 99. Ja, passt ja alles. Gut, gucken wir uns mal kurz die Softs an.
Softs. One of the two ancient races of Proxtray. They lived in a highly advanced culture that valued the community ahead of the individual, which put them in conflict with the Lukers. The Softs used base 4 in their mathematics, and their organization was based on units of 4 to make up sets of 100.
Und das ergibt schon keinen Sinn für mich. So, dann ist ja dieser Meteorit, glaube ich, Skite.
Scythe. A large asteroid in an elliptical orbit in the Alpha Proxima system. Spectral analysis of its composition indicates that it has minimal atmosphere and that it was once a moon of the planet Proxtra, hurled out of its orbit by a catastrophe. The 17th letter of the Lukar alphabet is named Scythe, probably not by coincidence.
Gibt's da auch einen Eintrag drüber?
Proxtra, the third planet in the Alpha Proxima system. This class M planet is widely habitable except for zones of extreme radioactivity on the southern continent. About 1,000 years ago, the two dominant political systems, the Lukers and the Softs, engaged in a nuclear war that resulted in the deaths of 3/4 of the world's population through direct or collateral damage. Proxtra's current civilization is non-spacefaring and does not have contact with the Federation.
Na gut. Dann gucken wir noch, was Spooky zu sagen hat, und dann beamen wir uns runter.
I suggest we beam down, sir. The surface is hostile, but survivable for a short time.
Okay, dann machen wir das doch mal.
Spock, come with me.
Beamen Mr. Scott, runter.
You have the car. We didn't notice anything beaming down.
Just a glitch in the main transporter program. Mr. Kyle is loading a backup and we're performing tests. The transporters will be down for about an hour.
That will still give us plenty of time, Scotty.
I know. I have the lads in engineering doing a complete overhaul of the ship's systems.
Good, Mr. Scott. I'll keep you posted. Kirk out.
Jo, schön gut. Dann sehen wir uns hier erst einmal um auf diesem tollen Planeten.
There are many rocks here.
Nein, da wäre ich nie drauf gekommen.
This is the planet Proxtra, currently 600,000 kilometers from this moon.
Yo, super.
This looks like a heavy-duty security door built into the side of a hill on this moon.
Was sagt Spock's Wunderwaffe?
Unremarkable except for low-grade power emanations from the door area. The rocks have a high quantity of triphosphorus silver in them. I cannot get readings from this range, Captain. But if we do not hurry, there will be nothing left to get a reading on.
Ja, da hat er wohl recht. Okay, nehmen wir mal einen dieser Steine, wenn es geht. Ja, es geht.
You retrieve a rock.
Stark. Und dann gehen wir mal zu dieser Tür hin. Ja.
Captain, I'm afraid we got a wee problem here.
What is it, Scotty?
There is some sort of virus in the main computer. Our phasers and tractor beams have been disabled, and there's no way we're getting them back in 3 hours.
There goes our backup plan. Do what you can, Mr. Scott.
Aye, I will, Captain. I may yet have a trick or two that I can pull, but don't count on any miracles.
Isolate that virus. That's your number one priority.
That it is, Captain. We'll keep you informed. Scott out.
Sure.
This heavy-duty door has taken numerous micrometeorite strikes, but still appears solid. Alain sits above the doorway, but is it mere decoration? It looks like some sort of display panel.
Mm-hmm.
This is a keypad that looks functional.
Mm. Okay, was hat Spock wunderbar dazu? Gucken.
There is power running to the keypad.
Gut, das hatten wir eben schon.
A working display panel, Captain.
Ja, soweit so klar.
The door still appears to be in operating condition.
Das hätte ich mir schon fast gedacht. Und was ist mit dem Ding da oben? Yo, klasse, eine doppelte Linse. Naja, whatever. Wir müssen jetzt hier rein.
Spock, see what you can do with that lock.
Und ganz ehrlich, dieses Rätsel, also die beiden Rätsel, die jetzt sind, hier dieses hier und das direkt danach, haben mich echt um den Verstand gebracht, muss ich schon sagen, ja. Ich habe fast eine Stunde daran herumgerätselt und versucht selber herauszufinden, wie dieser Code ist, aber ich bin da einfach nicht drauf gekommen. Ich habe mir dann externe Hilfe geholt und der Code für diese Tür ist 10200. Spock erklärt auch gleich, warum das der richtige Code ist, aber irgendwie habe ich das nicht kapiert. Also wenn ihr da eine Logik hintererkennt und versteht, warum dieser Code so ist, wie er ist, dann erklärt es mir bitte, denn ich bin, glaube ich, zu blöde dafür.
Ah, that worked. I see you deduced that 10200 in the Lucre's base 3 was equal to their sacred number 99.
Ja, die Frage ist nur, wie kommt man bei Base 3 da drauf, dass 10.299 entspricht? Verblüffend, ne?
Report, Scotty. How are things going?
About as badly as a kilt in a blast furnace, Captain. Wait a minute. Lieutenant Uhura has some news for you.
The virus came from our sensor sweep of the moon's computers. We believe we have analyzed the memory sectors it attacked.
Well done, Uhura.
I wish I could take credit for it. It was Mr. Kyle who found the pattern. We are attacking it with antivirus programs.
Computer science sounds more like medicine every day.
If we had a doctor as good with computers as you are with patients, we'd be having a lot fewer problems.
Finally someone who appreciates me.
Keep working at it, Uhura. Kirk out.
Gut. Was haben wir hier? Spock's Sonderwaffe?
A computer terminal, Captain. It uses the Lucre alphabet. I think I can decipher it.
Okay.
The interior of the security lock is unremarkable and well preserved.
Mhm. So, was haben wir hier drüben?
This keypad is fully functional and controls the door. Its entry code is in base 3. This door is similar to the one on the outside of the secure lock, except that it has not weathered over the years. Electrical panels indicate the keypad on the right controls the door.
Aber hier, da ist nichts zum Scannen. Dann lassen wir Spock das Ding mal im Allgemeinen benutzen.
Spock, see what you can do with this.
Mal sehen, was da mit anstellen kann.
The console reports the following.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome to Orbital Missile Base. Codename Scythe. This base has been operational for the past week. It has completed one successful fire mission. Estimation of success is at 22 over 100.
22%? That's very low. Hardly something to brag about.
Doctor, in base 3, 22 divided by 100 is equivalent to 8 out of 9, or 88%. I would think that quite satisfactory, given this base's probable mission of destroying the soft forces on Proxtree.
It says the base has been operational for a week, but this has been here for 1,000 years.
If the Lucres built this base with a clock that told the time by measuring the moon's rotational speed, or the gravitational forces generated by Proxtree and the sun, the computer may have calculated only a week of time has passed since its first action. I might be able to learn more with another look at the console. There is a substantial amount of data here, but in summary, Scythe was created by the Lucres as a launching platform for missiles to keep the Sofs subjugated to their influence. The Sofs managed to infiltrate the base. However, their actions triggered Scythe's auto-attack mechanisms and initiated a holocaust that nearly annihilated the planet. One soft strike did, in fact, hit the moon and deflected it from its orbit. It has been dormant since then.
So why has the base been activated again?
Given the damage to the moon, its slow rotation and orbit, it has never realized the war is over. On this pass, for the first time, It has detected radio wave transmissions from Proxtree.